Photoshop fans, welcome back to onestoptutorials.com. My name's Alibaba, and in this video tutorial, we're going to be doing something really, really funky. Okay, we're going to be using the stamp tool. Now, I'm a great fan in Adobe of using manipulative tools, and this one is just, it is an amazing tool. It was very similar to the healing brush tool. Okay, so this is how you use it. Simply left click on the stamp tool and you get two types of stamp tools. One's a clone stamp tool, the other one's a pattern stamp tool. We're going to go over the clone stamp tool first. Now when you've clicked on that, you find yourself, you have again, like you do in most of the other tools, have some options up here. You have some different modes, which we'll go into later when we start getting into modes and everything, but just be aware they're here. You've also again got the size of your brush, the style of your brush. Here we are again with opacity, if you bring the opacity up to 100 and let's say we click on the dog, you see that it's 100. If we brought it down to something a bit less, like 15, clicked on it, it just you have to click a few times to get the similar effect. Okay, next then, let me move that back to 100. Next we have the flow, which is and this airbrush tool connects to this flow percentage. So you click the airbrush tool, and then with 100% selected, this would start in the middle and work its way out. If you see, it starts in the middle and then it keeps expanding. If we were to bring down the percentage to, let's say, 18, it would start slower and eventually work its way out. Okay, so it's a very funky tool. Align. Okay, what align means, if we have a line selected, I'm going to show you how to do it all first, and then I'm going to explain exactly what keys you need to do. So let's say, for instance, we wanted to take his head. So I'd click on his eye, hold down Alt, left click on his eye, and then up here I would draw his eye. Okay, so as you can see, we got his head. Now with the line selected, I can sort of work out that roughly his tail and his legs are back here, so I can carry on moving around and would be able to eventually find his tail and his legs. Okay, and we could make a complete duplicate of Bruno. In fact, I don't think I introduced this dog. This dog is my dog. It's a Dachshund. Its name's Bruno, and as loyal as they get, really. Anyway, so that's what happens when you have the aligned selected. Now if we unclicked the align button and we did the same thing, we selected his eye by holding down Alt and then pasted it over here. Okay, if we did the same thing where we expect his tail and his legs to be back here, well, without align selected, what happens basically is you make another duplicate of the same area, and again and again. So it just, depending on the effect that you want to do, it's either a good tool or not such a good thing. I like to keep a line checked. Okay, so that's basically the tools. Now, as you could have seen what we were doing just then, all you're doing is you're holding down Alt to select an area. Okay, so I hold down Alt to select this leaf and left click on the mouse. That now tells the system I have selected this area. So wherever I go in the picture and I start to paint, I will get from that selected area. You'll be able to see at the moment there's a cross on that area. If I move over here, the cross moves and I start copying that area. You can see I'm getting the lead here. Okay, so that's the way the system works. I'm going to quickly revert this image by F12, which will bring back the original image. Okay, now what we want to do in this tutorial is we want to clean this picture up. We've got a picture of my great dog Bruno, and it's all messy. This is my typical garden. We're not green people, should I say. We don't have green fingers. So what we're going to do is we're going to do exactly the same method. I like to use a small feathered brush, and we're just going to click and we're going to take away. Okay, we're just going to work away around the picture, tidying it up. And every time we want to select a new area, remember we got to hold down Alt to do so. So hold down Alt, and we're just going to take it, clean all this up. Let's get hold of that. Just clean it all up. Let's get rid of this area. Okay, these leaves. Now you really could get very obsessive about it. I do. You can come out with some great effects. Let's get rid of this, and I'm gonna try to do this a little bit quicker, because I'm sure you guys and girls out there have other things to be doing with your lives. But I just want to show you the rough idea of how this tool works. We're just gonna keep going through, and I just keep clicking alt, selecting an area, and then painting over it in the new area. It's an amazing, in fact, it's just like magic. Again, I shall quote Paul Daniels, it's just like magic. And we're gonna plod our way through, tidying it up, trying not to take hours in doing so. And that's probably about right. I mean, I would go into it more, but we just don't have the time. And I also like to keep quite close. So this darkness area, I mean, we've got a light area under here. I generally click under it and keep to the same color area. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna revert this image, meaning I'm gonna bring back the original image. So I'm gonna hit F12. Okay, there it is there. Okay, now I'm gonna hit Control Z, and I'm gonna bring back what we just did, and I want you to be able to see the difference. Look at that. Look at all this area, all this rubbish area down here, up along here. I mean, we've just cleaned up the whole image. Now you just have the focus on the dog, and we could come in more, we could come in here and tidy this around his back, we could zoom in and tidy that up. But look at the difference it's made in such a short time. I mean, it's an amazing tool. I highly recommend to use it. You can really come out with some nice effects. And there you go, look at that, excellent. Okay, so I hope you got an understanding of the stamp tool. The pattern stamp tool is very similar. You select, but instead you're choosing from a pattern. You can upload patterns to your C drive, program files, and where your Adobe is. And then when we select a pattern, we're just simply cloning in a pattern. Okay, so that's how that works. I hope you've enjoyed the video tutorial. Please subscribe to my YouTube or leave comments below. And if you've got any questions at all, something's not happening the way it should be, send me an email and I will try my best to help out. Take it easy, guys and girls. See you to the next video tutorial.